of the Final Four continues on CBS with a Big Ten encounter this afternoon between the Michigan Wolverines and the Purdue Boilermakers. Good afternoon, everybody. Vern Lundquist along with Clark Kellogg in a pivotal game, Clark, for both these teams.
Well, when you think about Purdue, they've already got a home loss in conference play. You don't want to get two of those back-to-back. Michigan improving as a team, but they've struggled on the road. They'd like to get a road win.
Michigan comes in 3-3. Purdue has lost their last two games. Here are the lineups. On the left, you see the Michigan starting lineup. The strength there in the backcourt with Bobby Reed and Lewis Bullock. On the right, the Purdue starting five, significant. They go with a three-guard look, and Carson Cunningham gets his first start today in a Purdue uniform, a transfer from Oregon State. Brian Ellaby in his second year, his first full season as the full-time coach, not the interim coach. Record of 34-19, and in his 19th season as the head coach of Purdue, Gene Katy. Six Big Ten titles during that time and 14 NCAA appearances. Purdue has not lost three straight Big Ten games in 5 years, 6 years actually, when they dropped back-to-back-to-back games to Indiana, Illinois, and Northwestern. They were thumped here by Indiana, a rare loss at home, and then they were devastated in a trip to Ohio State.
They really never got anything going offensively in Columbus. The three-guard alignment hopefully allows them to create more scoring opportunities for themselves.
And here is Carson Cunningham, number 43. Sat out last year after transferring back. He was a starter at Oregon State in his freshman season. Allen Elbridge back in the starting lineup. Now Brian Cardinal, one of the tri-captains. Cunningham looks inside. Greg McQuay, who has been a solid front court player for Purdue this year. Shot clock at five. Jerron Cornell with the first shot of the game, and he gets the soft bounce. It goes in. Now Robbie Reed. He's picked up by Cunningham. Brandon Smith, number 34, and back into the hands of Reed. Looks inside. McNear has it go through his hands. Cornell thinks about the three. Cardinal will take it. Off the mark, foul. He'll shoot three times.
Poor foul there. You want to challenge the jump shooter, but you want to make sure you don't make any contact. Cardinal has really been struggling from the perimeter. So you don't want to bail him out and send him to the line.
Matter of fact, this Purdue team in the last two games has been horrid in three-point range. Now Cardinal will shoot. There's the first. Double figures, 53 of 85. And a 37% career average from three-point range.
He's a capable three-point shooter, but he and Jerron Cornell both have really struggled in the absence of Chad Austin and Brad Miller, because the kinds of shots they get now and the kinds of defenders they see now, totally different than what they saw a year ago. They could pick and choose their spots. And I talked to Brian Cardinal before the game. He said he had a wonderful rapport with Brad Miller. They kind of knew where each other was going to be, and he suffered from his absence.
Cardinal hits all three, a 5-0 lead. Here's Brandon Smith. Nice penetration. Off the mark. Rebound, offensive. Aslan can't get the pass, and here comes Cornell for Purdue. Scoop shot, Cunningham, drive, kicks it back. Greg McQuay takes the shot and gets it. A 7-0 Purdue start. Exactly what they had hoped for.
Shooting percentage is always a function of the kinds of shots you get. Purdue on Tuesday night could not find a good quality shot in the early going. Here today, they've gotten high quality shots in their first few possessions.
Gene Katy's crew has lost its last four of its last six games. They come in 2-3 in conference play, and he was really singing the blues yesterday.
Well, he wanted his team to play with more energy, more emotion, more enthusiasm, more heart, as he said. And one way to generate that kind of energy is by getting off to a good start.
Well, and he tweaked the lineup. He's gone with his third lineup in as many games, and Cunningham getting his first start. Here's Robbie Reed. Brandon Smith
if Michigan, out of the timeout, tries to find a way to get Lewis Bullock a shot. He's being guarded by Jerron Cornell.
And closely guarded right now. Here's Robbie Reed, gets the screen from Aslan, takes the shot, and Michigan is on the board.
Well, when you look at Michigan and what they do offensively, the bulk of their perimeter shots are going to come from Reed and Bullock, and both players are having really good shooting years.
Now Cunningham, guarded by Brandon Smith. Penetration, left-handed shot up and off the glass. Purdue perfect in the early going now, 3 of 3 from the field to start. Brandon Smith, nice move.
Oh, well done. Nice little curl move, and he's their most athletic and probably most versatile player, and he showed you a little bit of that right there.
McNear boarded McQuay and paid for it. Nice pass.
Both teams have started man-to-man. Both teams will on occasion show zone. So we'll keep an eye on that. But right now, Purdue getting just the kind of shots they want each time down.
And Bullock, working hard to get a shot, gets his first. It's off the mark. Offensive board, though, for Michigan. Cardinal fronting Aslan. McNear top of the key, and Reed will take the three. Rebound in the hands of Eldridge. Now Cunningham, right side to Cornell, has trouble handling it. Skip pass, Eldridge for three, way off the mark. Offensive board. Cornell for three, got it.
Second shot opportunities. Purdue had a couple of good practices on the heels of that Ohio State loss. And it's obvious that the practices have transferred to the game production here early.
Aslan goes down with Cardinal. And Cardinal comes up holding the ball. Welcome to those of you who've just watched the conclusion of the Providence-Arkansas game. Purdue jumping out to a 7-0 lead. They now have a 10-point edge, and Arkansas convincing in its win over Providence today.
A bit surprising when you looked at that game on paper. You felt it would be closer than that, but Arkansas hit a little bit of a speed bump and obviously broke out of it in a big way today.
Now, Leon Jones has come off the bench for Michigan. Brian Ellaby has made the first substitution in the ball game. Jones wearing number 0 and a tussle away from the ball. Cameron Stevens also came in during the hell ball, and he gets the foul.
We take a look at Jerron Cornell. Nice movement without the ball. Bullock late getting to him, and Cornell, a 45% career three-point shooter. When he has daylight, he makes you pay.
And Chris Young, who is off the bench, is called for the foul for Michigan.
Well, partner, you won't have to worry too much about a lot of substitutions for the Wolverines. Chris Young and Jones, probably the only two guys you'll see off that Michigan bench.
Well, it cuts down on the homework. And another foul. This one called on Bullock. Greg McQuay. Mike Robinson also on for Gene Katie. Started most of the year, but has been ineffective offensively recently, so Katie has him on the bench. Beautiful feed from McQuay to Cunningham.
Well, I tell you what, this is a totally different team than the one we saw on Tuesday night. They couldn't make any plays offensively. But again, a couple of good days of practice focusing on ball movement, spacing, and playing to have some fun. And they're off to a great start today.
Robbie Reed with the penetration, but he's off the front iron. Purdue 6 of 7. Here's the Cunningham penetration. McQuay gets another. And it was created by Cunningham's drive to the basket.
Penetration always breaks down the interior defense. Greg McQuay able to benefit.
This is a Purdue team in its last four games that has averaged 40% from the field.
Well, they're doing a great job today, Vernon, getting the ball inside, and the quality of their shots has been excellent. One open three, and then everything else has been pretty much in the paint area.
Carson Cunningham, he's an Indiana native, was not highly recruited by Purdue. They had another young man in mind, so he opted to accept a scholarship to Oregon State, where he started in his freshman year. Told Gene Katie, I'm coming back. The young man that Purdue had recruited didn't work out. Katie said, I don't encourage transfers, but I said, you come and you'll play.
Well, he's giving him a nice lift today, and as a freshman in the Pac-10, was runner-up to Mike Bibby's freshman of the year out there. Averaged 15 points a game in his first season, and really has given this team a nice lift here in the first 5 minutes.
Tony Mayfield is on for Purdue. Bullock gets the free throw. And Purdue has exploded out of the starting run.
You know, I've played in the U.S. and Canada, so I've got friends all over. That's why I use 1010-220. It's only 99 cents up to 20 minutes and just 10 cents a minute after that within the U.S. or to Canada. So when I call my buddy Phelan here in the States, or my brother in Canada, it's just 99 cents all day, every day. With 1010-220, all your calls can be under a buck. Hey, little brother, go long. Pause for it every time.
Hey! Hey!
The executives are at the gate. Around the first turn, that's Bill Williams leading Miss Kelly Mack on the outside and Jane Carlson. As they pass the car rental counters, Kelly Mack has to stop to fill out paperwork. Now it's Jane Carlson and Bill Williams neck and neck. Bill has to leave the airport to get his car, but Jane's car is right there at Hertz number one Club Gold. The trunk is open. The keys are in it. It's Jane Carlson and Hertz number one Club Gold. Exactly.
Security breach, sir. Somehow Johnson's had a pizza delivered.
A delivery boy just waltzed in here?
Fancy crust? Toppings? Looks that way, sir.
Find him. Now!
Rising crust pizza that bakes up fresh like pizzeria pizza. It's not delivery. It's DiGiorno.
Here, taste.
CBS Sports coverage of the road to the Final Four is sponsored by Volvo. Volvo reminds you to drive safely. Kinko's, express yourself. And by Applebee's Neighborhood Grill and Bar. You belong at Applebee's.
14,123 on hand. That's the norm here at Mackey Arena. Another sellout. Big Ten encounter between the Michigan Wolverines and the Purdue Boilermakers. 18-6 the score. And Purdue 7 of 8 from the field. Points in the paint, 10.
Exactly. That's the point that I would emphasize. The fact that Purdue is getting an awful lot of stuff in the paint area as a result of good ball movement and good player movement.
9-2 run. They jumped out to a 7-0 lead in the first 90 seconds of the ball game. Now Tony Mayfield is on in the point position for the Boilermakers. Mike Robinson, Alan Eldridge, Cardinal, and Cameron Stevens. That's the quintet on the floor. Here Stevens picks it out right side.
Brian Ellerby has decided, excuse me, Byrne, to go to the zone in an effort to try to force Purdue to take perimeter shots instead of being able to get things in the paint. And on that possession, they get the missed field goal and get possession of the ball.
Chris Young inbound, puts it in the hands of Leon Jones. He's the freshman from Battle Creek, Michigan. Jones, Reed, nice pass underneath to Young. Too strong. And the ball may have been touched. Cardinal got another. A 14-point Purdue lead. Now Reed, guarded by Mayfield. Bullock in the lane for two. Bullock averaging 22 points a game. That's his first bucket.
If Michigan can somehow put together some stops, Lewis Bullock has enough versatility in his game to go on a run by himself from a point production standpoint and get his team back in it.
Cardinal saves it for Purdue. Here's Robinson, finds Cardinal. Good rotation by Big Neer, but picks up the foul.
Here you take a look at Brian Cardinal. In transition after the miss and rebound, Purdue beats the defense down the floor, and Brian Cardinal able to get an easy one. Cardinal working the baseline on their next possession. And I don't know if they gave that to Big Neer or Jones.
Gave it to Jones.
Jones from behind.
Fourth team foul. Katie's going to his bench, and Jerron Cornell back in for Tony Mayfield. Cardinal shoots one more. Point edge. Cardinal with 7 points in the early going. A little pressure applied defensively by Purdue. Here's Leon Jones. Cornell has him. Bullock is really having trouble getting open. Big Neer. Young back to Bullock. Alan Eldridge, the senior tri-captain, guards it. And the shot clock at 10. Reed puts it up and will go to the free throw line.
Well, you're right. Purdue is going to be able to put two or three different guys on Bullock, give him different looks, try to wear him down, try to really make him work to get shooting opportunities. And that means somebody else is going to have to be able to break down the defense as Robbie Reed did on that possession.
Bullock needs four. Only four others have ever gone to 2,000. And there's a rare miss. Now Katie's going back to his, or rather Ellerby going back to his bench. Aslan and Brandon Smith back on the floor. Whoa!
Never had a chance.
Because of the expertise of Reed and Bullock at the free throw line, this is the best free throw shooting team in the Big Ten.
Also the best three-point shooting team in the Big Ten, but you wouldn't have known it in terms of the free throw that time by Reed.
Robbie Reed misses two. He's an 82% free throw shooter. We're under 13 minutes in the first half. Here's Cornell. Robinson, turnover. Brandon Smith ahead to Reed. Takes the three. Way off the mark. The putback finally. Aslan gets two. And Michigan in double figures. Robinson finds Cameron Stevens. Cardinal. Stevens manages to hold it. From the baseline, Cornell. Rebound, Big Neer. Robbie Reed. Brandon Smith back to Reed. Pops another three. In and out. And a foul on the loose ball. Sunday on CBS, legendary outlaws come out of retirement to help a son avenge his father's murder. Willie Nelson, Kris Kristofferson, Waylon Jennings, and Travis Tripp. star in the CBS Sunday movie Outlaw Justice tomorrow night on CBS. Time call here at Mackey Arena in West Lafayette, Indiana.
Very good. I must say, I'm amazed.
I am a very stylish girl.
The new Volvo S80. My goodness.
A very stylish girl.
Protect the body, ignite the soul.
Used to be, if I want something done right, I called me. It worked. Until I tried to quit smoking. I needed more than me. I got Nicorette. Nicorette helped me two ways. I used it on a regular schedule to help prevent my cravings, and for unexpected cravings, I was ready with an extra piece. I used to be a slave to cigarettes. Nicorette helped me hang on, helped me win. Now that I'm nicotine free, I gotta tell you, it feels good to win.
Only Nicorette helps you control your cravings. You'll have it two ways. You can do it. Nicorette can help.
So, how's the broker biz?
Hey, my client made $2,000 on the market, and he owed it all to me.
What, did you give him some good advice?
No, I meant he owed it to me. In commissions.
Who's looking out for your investments? E-Trade, the number one rated place to invest online. Get free real-time quotes, 10 times more research, IPOs, all from $14.95. Isn't it time you looked out for number one? Call 1-800-E-TRADE-1 and see why someday we'll all invest this way.
Breakthrough to the new world of Mach 3 from Gillette. The first triple blade shaving system. Three blades specially positioned to shave progressively closer. You take one stroke, it takes three. So you don't have to shave the same area over and over, which means less irritation. Three blades, fewer strokes, less irritation. Mach 3 from Gillette.
CBS Sports coverage of the road to the Final Four. Is sponsored by Volvo. Volvo reminds you to drive safely. Kinko's, express yourself. And by Applebee's Neighborhood Grill and Bar. You belong at Applebee's.
Michigan trailing 22-10. We're back at Mackey Arena in West Lafayette. It was Purdue jumping out to an 18-4 lead. The Wolverines have shaved a little bit off that margin.
And I think they can continue to shave points off that deficit as you look at what Reed and Bullock have done. Obviously, those two guys have to get going. But defensively, by going to the zone, they've been able to negate the inside action Purdue was able to be successful with early on. So if they can rebound and run out of the zone a little bit and get Reed and Bullock off, they'll be able to get back in this game.
Here's Brandon Smith. That's off the front iron. Into the corner, chased down by Aslan. Brian Cardinal has gone to the bench with two fouls. There's Reed. Brandon Smith. And Robbie Reed. Cunningham back on the floor. Nice dish. And the shot will not fall. Rebound to Gary McQuay, Greg McQuay's brother. And Cornell kicks it back to Carson Cunningham. Gary McQuay wearing number 5. And his brother Greg McQuay, number 32. They are from Gary, Indiana. Here's the shot from Cornell. Not there. Chased down by Reed.
Nice job of transitioning back defensively by Purdue.
Reed. Gary McQuay comes out. And Robbie Reed goes right by him.
That's just good recognition. Reed had a step on his defender. Small on big. Took advantage of it.
10-point edge for Purdue.
See, Purdue came out with an awful lot of energy and emotion. As you would expect, they're on the heels of two losses. They've had two or three good days of practice. Now Michigan has started to bother them a little bit with this zone. And if Michigan can just maintain poise and get some shots and rebound out of the zone, they can fight their way back into it.
Eldridge has to take the shot with two on the shot clock. No good. There's the penetration off the glass. They fight for it offensively. Brandon Smith back to Reed for three. Yes. Here they come. Somewhat reminiscent of the Michigan State-Iowa game two nights ago.
Exactly.
That one in East Lansing when Iowa jumped out to a 19-4 lead and Michigan State came back. Here's the counter for Cunningham. And that puts an edge and end to the Michigan run. Reed. Lewis Bullock guarded now by Eldridge. Cornell on Smith. Nice move off the glass.
Right to the rack. I really like this young fella's game, Burn. He can handle it. He's what I would call a small stat sheet stuffer because the volume of his versatility isn't that great, but he does a little bit of everything.
Brandon Smith, a sophomore from Amarillo, Texas, where he played at Paladuro High School. And that foul is going to be called underneath on Michigan.
Brandon Smith showing you some of his versatility at 6'7". Excellent ball handling skills allows him to go from the foul line right to the cup.
That foul called on Brandon Smith, so Brian Ellerby gives him a rest. Chris Young back on the floor, number 45. Eldridge into the corner. Cunningham. Cornell for three. Nice job on the boards offensively from McQuay, but it's out of bounds off Purdue.
You're exactly right. That was a tremendous effort to get to that offensive board. And Greg McQuay has been their most consistent player all year long. Take a look at his action inside. That actually was Gary. Was that Gary?
Yep.
I figured I'd get him crossed up once today.
Bullock. It's not there for Lewis Bullock in the early going. Here comes Cunningham for Purdue. Reed picks him up. Blocking foul called on Robbie Reed. Who's the best player in college basketball? Track the favorites and contenders in the Wooden Award Watch at cbs.sportsline.com or on America Online at keyword CBS Sportsline. Well, you mentioned the Wooden Award, and you think of Purdue and John Wooden, one of the illustrious players to ever play here, of course. Then the famous UCLA head coach. 1-1 now, Purdue in the bonus.
An awful lot of movement there. It would have been a violation had that shot not gone down.
Cunningham will shoot one more.
Cunningham broke his wig down from Tuesday night. He kind of had the Eddie Munster look going. And some of the students at Ohio State during that game on Tuesday got on him. But I talked to him about cutting his hair. And he said that didn't have much to do with it. I woke up at 2 or 3 o'clock in the morning frustrated by the loss and decided I needed to do something. And he took about half of it, actually two-thirds of it off. That's what he looked like on Tuesday. And now he's got the much closer crew cut.
Yeah, it's got that Paris Idol look. Definitely. Underneath to Brandon Smith. Robinson defending. Leon Jones gets it. Short. Rebound. Into the hands of Greg McQuay, number 32, and a foul on Jones. Brian Ellerby, 35 years of age, coach at Loyola of Maryland for 3 years, became an assistant to Steve Fisher, got the interim title last year. It was removed in March. And all in all, given the expectations, a pretty decent, more than a decent job.
Yeah, I would agree with you wholeheartedly there, Vern.
Triple header for you tomorrow. We began with a terrific game, Duke St. John's. Then you'll see South Carolina, Syracuse, or Missouri, Kansas. And then Clark and I are going to move down the state and watch Michigan State take on Indiana in another Big Ten game. 7:53 to go first half. Boilermakers by 11.
I like this kid.
Mm-hmm.
Let's give her a shot.
Shrimp, plump and cayenne spice. Now appearing with Applebee's tender Bourbon Street steak that's Cajun rubbed to seal in the juices. All on a hot iron skillet with rice and sautéed mushrooms. It's a lot of spice for the price. So don't miss it. Come in today.
The kids definitely got it.
Definitely.
How do I look?
Very good. I must say, I'm amazed.
I am a very stylish girl.
The new Volvo S80.
My goodness.
A very stylish girl.
Protect the body, ignite the soul.
My job is to compare products. And it's not often that I'm surprised. So when Head & Shoulders went up against the leading prescription brand, I expected the prescription to be better, but it isn't. A study proves Head & Shoulders is effective against dandruff. I found out there's a microscopic fungus associated with dandruff, and Head & Shoulders helps kill it, helps stop flakes before they even start. Not even the expensive prescription works better. You may never see flakes again. I don't.
Who are you?
I was hired by your roommate.
Well, out of my way, I want a Bud Light.
I don't think so.
This is ridiculous. I live here.
Sorry. You ain't on the list.
List? Is there a problem, Bruno?
Nothing I can't handle.
That's what I like to hear.
For the great taste that won't fill you up and never let you down, make it a Bud Light.
Now am I on your list?
Let's see.
Nope.
Here's the Bud Light summary. 28-17 to score. Both teams frigid from three-point range.
Yeah, you take a look at what Purdue has done overall, 56% shooting, so you know they're doing a good job getting the ball inside. And Michigan shoots over 40% as a team coming into the game from behind the three-point line. But there's the story. First start here as a Purdue Boilermaker. Carson Cunningham changed his locks, and unlike Sampson, when he shedded his hair and lost his strength, Cunningham has shedded his and given the Boilermakers a nice little ignition here early.
Cunningham 3 of 3 from the field and perfect from the free throw line, as is this Purdue team. That's where the edge is, one of the edges. They're 9 of 9, and Michigan is only 2 of 4 at the line, as Robbie Reed missed too. Foul is on Cunningham. That is the fifth Purdue foul. Team foul. Brandon Smith will inbound.
Michigan just wants to maintain contact. Stay within 6, 8, 9 points. Make sure they get good shots every trip down. And try to shake Bullock free. Now you see another guy guarding him. Tony Mayfield on him now. You've seen Elridge on him. Cunningham's been on him a little bit. Mike Robinson may guard him.
Leon Jones backs out. And he traveled.
Undecided. Here you take a look at Lewis Bullock, weak side away from the ball. Never got swung back around to his side. And the Wolverines turned it over.
Well, Bullock, fresh from a 33-point outing at Minnesota in the last game. He's 1 for 5 today. The shots have been tough to find, and he's only hit one of them. Nice touch pass underneath for Cunningham. He gets the feed back, kicks it back outside. Pretty play. Didn't get the shot. Now Tony Mayfield. Stevens underneath to Greg McQuaid.
Well done. Nice little high-low work that time. Stevens and McQuaid connected. But again, that's all about ball movement and player movement. Here's Bullock from deep.
1 of 6.
Nice job by the Boilermakers here. You get the ball to the middle of the floor, and then Stevens finds the alert Greg McQuaid inside.
Foul is on Cameron Stevens, his second. That's the sixth Purdue team foul. And Bullock will inbound. Here's Chris Young back to Robbie Reed. Bullock in the corner.
Boy, they've got a mismatch down low. Asman, as Purdue is in the zone.
Asman finds Young.
Exactly. Good high low act. Good work that time by the big fellas. Coming to the ball against the zone, and Purdue, not a very big team across the front line. Michigan able to take advantage of it on that trip.
Another foul on Robbie Reed. That's his second.
You take a look at Josh Asland stepping out. That allows room for Young to flash to the ball and take advantage of his size against the smaller Purdue defender down in that zone.
Asland, who had some serious foul difficulties in the early going, has really, he fouled out of 8 games, but 7 of those before they got into conference play, and that has not been effective. Here's Jones from Reed. Asland back in the hands of Robbie Reed. Cunningham has it. Robbie Reed and Cunningham again. Leon Jones goes left. Nice drive. And again, the shot won't fall.
Just can't quite finish. You're right. Good penetration. And then no second shot that trip.
Cunningham gets a little out of control, and there's a turnover. That's only the second Purdue turnover. Skip pass to Jones, 3-point effort. Nope. Cunningham, he'll run. Reed back defensively playing the 2 fouls, and Cunningham cans it.
Tough, tough shot there, but that's what he brings to the table. The ability to step on the gas pedal and get them some opportunities in transition.
Carson Cunningham, 12 points already. Another miss. Offensive board, the putback too strong. And Gary McQuay comes out for Purdue. Here's Cunningham again. Underneath the touch pass, and Robbie Reed is fouled by Cornell. And let's look again at Carson Cunningham.
Well, again, in transition, when you've got guys backpedaling, when you've got the ball, if you've got skills, you've got to feel like you can get a good shot off when defenders are backpedaling. That was a tough try, but a good result, and he's had a huge first half with 12 points.
And it's not like he's played a lot in Big Ten play, Clark. He's been limited in his contributions off the bench.
Exactly. I mean, he had played 32 minutes in the prior 4 games before... in the prior 5 games before getting the start today. Gene Cady must have sensed that starting Cunningham might work, but anytime you're struggling, you try to tweak things a little bit. You never know if things are going to work out well, but so far today, Cunningham making Gene Cady look like the outstanding coach that he's been for so long.
Cunningham rests, and Robbie Reed gets the first of 2.
Well, when you haven't played a lot of minutes in game action, you start taking a little bit of the oxygen out of the gym, and Cunningham needing a blow right now.
Robbie Reed has 9 points, 2 of 4 from the line. Maynard Lewis has come on in his place, getting his first action. This is Lewis with the ball, number 12. Gary McQuay, McQuay in the corner. Eldridge puts up the shot. Nice effort.
Well, against the zone, you either have to beat it with the perimeter shot, or you need to probe into the seams of the zone with the dribble or the pass.
Underneath, oh boy, it was a perfect setup, and it goes off the iron.
Pass was just a little too low.
Now Mayfield with Gary McQuay, Eldridge, Greg McQuay, and Maynard Lewis. From the corner, that shot blocked by Young. And Brian Ellaby's going to send Josh Asland back in the game. The first time has been called. 13-point Purdue edge.
Thank you. Honda. How will it affect you?
6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
AT&T WorldNet service. Just click and go.
Hate to tell you, but we're looking at a negative sales trend coupled with high overhead. Frankly, I'm worried about capital preservation. Let me put it this way. Look, we're just not meeting our goals. Tell you what, give me more eggs, I'll give you more corn. Otherwise, we may have to diversify.
Sometimes it's not just what you say, but how you say it. Kinko's, express yourself.
Is that Johnson's team behind us?
Exactly.
Are they members of Hertz Number One Club Gold?
Exactly.
Are we members of Hertz Number One?
Not exactly. So thanks to Hertz, they're going to get to the meeting on time.
And we'll be late.
So exactly what will I tell the boss?
In rent-a-car, there's Hertz, and there's not exactly. Make sure you choose the right one.
And then a dog in the cargo hold ate our patent paper.
Is he buying it?
Not exactly.
Back at Mackey Arena, 34-21 with 3:44 to go before the halftime break. And coming up at the Pennzoil at the half, Bonnie Bernstein will get you caught up on all the scores and highlights. And a look at the new King of Queens, St. John's, Ron Artest. That's all coming up at Pennzoil at the half. Well, 3:44 to go. A quick start for Purdue, and they've managed to maintain that edge throughout.
They've done that with good defense and also good ball movement, and they've gotten stellar play from Carson Cunningham. That's been the difference.
Right now, 34-21, 3:44 to go. And Cunningham will continue the rest. This Michigan team comes in with a 3-3 Big Ten record, but all three wins significant have been at home. And they're hitting only 30% in this ball game.
Well, they've done a nice job. Purdue has, as you look for the lob here. Nice job by Gary McQuay. Went up, got it, got himself under control, and then made a nice shot on the other side of the hoop. But Purdue has been very solid defensively, and the fact that they've been able to use their depth and give Lewis Bullock a number of different defenders to look at, I think it played a part in how well they've done defensively.
Bullock, 1 of 7 from the field. And right now it's Eldridge back on it. Brandon Smith, reach in foul. Maynard Lewis, number 12.
One of the things you don't ever want to be in is a hurry in the paint. Nice job to go up and get the orange here. One dribble to clear himself and extend. That's just good work by Gary McQuay inside, who actually has seen his minutes go down considerably this year from what he played last year, but continues to work and plug away and taking advantage of his opportunity on the floor today.
Gene Cady with a nice hand for his senior tri-captain, Alan Eldridge, who heads to the bench. And Brandon Smith, the free throw line. We'll shoot one more. On the floor now for Michigan, Vigneer, Young, Smith, Bullock, and Robbie Reed. Here's Cunningham back on the floor. Jerron Cornell into the corner. Skip pass. And a foul. I think they got Brandon Smith with this one. Not Vigneer.
Purdue taking an awful lot of taking advantage of the free throw situation. They've been to the line an awful lot in this first half. And that's been a problem area for Michigan. They're not a very big team, not a very big deep team. And they've sent the opponents to the line quite a bit.
Well, our coverage of the PGA Tour continues next week. Late night highlights of the Phoenix Open Thursday and Friday. And then complete third and fourth round coverage on Saturday and Sunday. Reed, 2.
Well done. Anytime you're struggling in your half court, anytime you can rebound and cleanly get it out and try to get something in your early offense, I think it gives you an advantage. And for players like Reed and Bullock, that's something they've got to try to do the rest of this half.
Cunningham penetrates, kicks it back out. Here is Gary McQuay. Shot too strong, and Robbie Reed comes out with it for Michigan. Hurries it up court. Bullock travels. Lewis Bullock with a modest game thus far.
And he's coming off a 33-point effort at Minnesota. We knocked down a handful of threes, but so far today, just 4 points and one assist. And you have to give credit to the Purdue defenders. He's seen two or three different guys on him, and they've been very effective in crowding him and not allowing him to get good looks at the basket.
This foul is going to be called on Michigan's Chris Young, the freshman from Plymouth, his second. And the 10th team foul, so the double bonus now. Here's Chris Young. Mike Robinson, one of six juniors on this Purdue team. That's the dominant age group for the Boilermakers. Robinson gets the first. John Allison, a freshman at 6'10", 215, makes his first appearance in the game. And Greg McQuay will rest. Bullock, now guarded by Robinson. Cunningham has Reed. Nice entry pass to Vic Neer. After the miss, Robinson goes baseline. Nifty move. Jerron Cornell got the pass from Robinson and puts it in.
And made it look so easy. That's because he's a smooth operator. Nice catch and finish. And Michigan just unable to put together consecutive scores. They'll come down and get one possession good and then two or three bad.
Vic Neer underneath. Had trouble handling the pass. Go back and take a look at that last Purdue basket.
Sweet move. Excellent catch. And then just a nice finish up and under by Jerron Cornell. But Purdue has done a nice job in the half court, attacking the man-to-man, especially they've gone inside. And then in their early offense, and they've beaten Michigan down the floor, they've taken advantage by getting the ball to the basket.
Peter Vic Neer will shoot one more. A 10-point edge in the paint.
Well, again, when you get the ball inside and you're finishing plays, you'll have that kind of advantage. Michigan has gotten it inside a few times, Vern, but they just haven't converted.
1:15 to go before the break. And a 14-point Purdue lead.
Well, Michigan was down double digits at Minnesota in the second half and came back to tie that game with about six minutes to go. So again, if they could just put together consecutive stops and get Bullock off and get back-to-back baskets, they could be right back in it.
Now here's Vic Neer after the Purdue miss. Brandon Smith. Bullock, 4 points in the first half. Takes it baseline and has it rejected. Cornell at the opposite end. And timeout called by Purdue. A 20-second timeout requested by Gene Cady. Now let's take you back a few years. Remember this? Michigan fans, I'm sure you can't forget. NCAA title game. Wolverines down by two with a chance to tie or take the lead. And Chris Webber. No timeouts remaining. A technical foul. Carolina won the national championship by six. And the Fab Five. Looks like Smokey Robinson in the mirror.
Boy, they were an exciting quintet, I guess is the appropriate word, but got the back-to-back Final Fours, and three of those guys continuing their basketball careers in the NBA, and Jimmy King had a time there, and Ray Jackson may, both of those guys may end up finding themselves on NBA rosters before too much longer.
Cunningham will not fall for him, and Smith. Loose ball, Allison and Young at the buzzer. Carson Cunningham, a sophomore from Ogden Dunes, Indiana. He has led the way. That's the end of the first half. Our score, 40-26. Bonnie Bernstein will be along with the Pennzoil at the half after this message.
Lou Gehrig was driven by it. It's been a part of Jordan's game, and it really gave Jenna the edge. For the past 75 years, it's been in a lot of great athletes, because it's been in every box of Wheaties, 100% whole grain, fueling champions for 75 years. Wheaties, let it fuel you. Hurry and vote today for your favorite Wheaties champion of all time. Top 10 boxes will be re-released. See box for details.
Officers here, here, and here, as well as sharpshooters here and here.
The sharpshooters. Where are they again?
Sometimes it's not just what you say, but how you say it. Kinko's. Express yourself.
These delicious moments are brought to you by Wendy's Monterey Ranch Chicken Sandwich. It's a juicy whole chicken breast fillet, Monterey Jack, and a creamy ranch sauce with real pieces of bacon.
This sandwich is the bomb.
You bet it is.
It's back.
Bernstein here in New York. Coming up on Pennzoil at the half, we'll take a look at the new King of Queens, Ron Artest of St. John's. After this message, and a word from your local station.
For just $2.29 a month. For details, call toll-free 1-877-36-LEASE. Alero by Oldsmobile. Start something.
For complete coverage of college basketball, news, scores, and stats, click on America Online at keyword CBS Sportsline or on the web cbs.sportsline.com.
Learn the secrets of martial arts star Sammo Hung. Log on to cbs.com.
Uh-oh, we got trouble.
Please not me. That's got to hurt.
Gracie!
We gotta do something. Charge!
She's back!
Let's go! Run, monkey! Run!
I'm not going to make it!
She's gonna eat monkey.
Not without milk.
Mom!
Got milk.
Who is the monkey now?
Some things don't taste their best the day they're made. You'd never drink wine the day they crush the grapes or eat a green banana.
No way, Dad.
And that's the secret to Papa John's traditional dough. We give the yeast several extra days to work its magic. We never use dough made the same day like some folks. Nature rewards those who exercise patience.
Better ingredients, better pizza. Papa John's.
Now, get a large Papa John's pizza with the works for just $10.99.
Big Ten test for the Boilermakers. We'll hear from Coach Katie tonight.
From Wish TV, your 24-hour news station, here's the latest from News 8.
Good afternoon. I'm Tina Cosby, and we'll get back to the game in just a moment. But first, the National Weather Service says the rains may have stopped for now in central Indiana, but Hoosiers could be in for some of the worst flooding in years if you're living in a certain area. Right now, it's dry but cloudy in central Indiana. Expect cooler temperatures tonight and tomorrow. Currently, it's 46 degrees downtown. This is News 8, your 24-hour news station.
Sports presents Pennzoil at the Half, sponsored by Pennzoil. Specially formulated for today's stop-and-go driving. Stop, go, Pennzoil.
Hi, everybody, and welcome to Pennzoil at the Half. I'm Bonnie Bernstein with the score at Mackey Arena. Purdue leading Michigan 40-26. Let's quickly get you caught up. College basketball elsewhere around the country. The Cats romping over the Bulldogs. Kentucky now 18-1 all-time against Mississippi State at Rupp. Number 8, Carolina, 52-40 over the Demon Deeks. Next up for them, number 2, Duke, coming up on Wednesday. Number 12, UCLA, 82-70 over Louisville. The Cards actually up 7 at the half, but the Bruins came back, shot 66% in the second half. And here's the turnaround story of the year. Number 24, Ohio State, struggling last year. They're now 15-5, 89-60 over number 17, Minnesota. And Arkansas romping all over the Providence Friars, 118-79. They lost to Bama earlier this week. Derek put a career-high 25 points. Now here's a look at the Chevrolet players of the Providence-Arkansas game. The Friars, Jamel Thomas, 30 points, 10 boards. And for Arkansas, Derek Hood, we mentioned, career-high 25 points on 12 of 14 shooting. Now remember, you can get all of your college basketball news simply by logging onto CBS Sportsline. Real easy to get the information. Just click on the America Online channel, Mark Sports, and then on the CBS Sportsline banner, or you can just go to keyword CBS Sportsline. Now when we come back, some might call him the King of Queens. Ron Artest of St. John's finds success right in his own backyard. Coming up when Pennzoil at the Half continues in just a minute.
It knows two speeds. Stop and go. It just beat a series of the toughest stop-and-go driving tests in the world, and it's brand new. Go ahead. Guess.
Guess.
You have 4.3 seconds. Introducing Pennzoil with new Pure Base. Stop. Go. Pennzoil.
Frequent heartburn. Is it worse at night, especially after dinner?
Mm-hmm.
Have you treated it, but still suffer on two or more days a week?
Mm-hmm.
Has your heartburn been a persistent problem for you?
Mm-hmm.
Your heartburn may be due to a potentially serious condition called acid reflux disease. Ask your doctor about Prilosec. Just one capsule daily can provide 24-hour complete heartburn relief. 24 hours. Ask your doctor for more information about Prilosec and if it's right for you. The most common side effects are headache, diarrhea, and abdominal pain. Want 24-hour heartburn relief with one daily dose? Ask your doctor about the 24-hour complete heartburn relief of Prilosec.
Introducing the Crest Extender, with gentle extender fibers to clean deep between teeth. The new Crest Extender.
He was a great teacher. He allowed me to get a little closer to my dreams, to express myself the way I wanted to express myself.
Be able to communicate with people, speak with them. They asked the right questions, getting me to question myself, question what I saw, think on my own.
Ideas that I'm going to take with me the rest of my life.
At Purdue University, step into a future with unlimited potential, a future where professors care about your success. Students learn cutting-edge knowledge from professors who are blazing the research trail. Choose among hundreds of majors that will prepare you for any career you can imagine. Head down the track to a world-class education. Hook up with Purdue University.
Hi, everyone, and welcome back to Pennzoil at the Half. Now, coming up tomorrow, the day will tip off at noon Eastern here on CBS with two of the top teams in the country. second-ranked Duke, and number 9, St. John's, taking the floor right here in New York City at Madison Square Garden. Now, St. John's is off to its best start since the 90-91 season, thanks in large part to a sophomore who kind of enjoys playing close to home.
One day, I just took a ball, and, you know, I just started playing. And then, just being a competitor that I am, as I got around the age 15 to 16, you know, I started getting my respect, and now people are seeing that I can play. Come out of high school, I said, well, I'll be like everybody else and go to the big school. St. John's just happened to be in Queens, and I'm from Queensbridge, and I wanted to stay in the city. I can't stay no more. I just love this city. A lot of people told me that I shouldn't have came here. Oh, it was crazy coming out of high school. Why did you go there? You're going to be just like what they say, Felipe, you know. I never paid attention to none of that. People say you're not going to make it there, and now we're in the top 8, you know. It's not over, but it's a good start.
While Felipe Lopez couldn't live up to his overblown hype, Artest has painted a different picture. St. John's is 16-3 now, causing Ron to speak of himself as the best player in the conference and of his team as a national title contender. For a sophomore, some rather bold statements.
When I first heard them, I'm saying to myself, who does he think he is, you know? But then when you see him play, and then you learn to appreciate how unselfishly he plays, you know, you realize that, you know, he probably means everything he says, and he never says it in a, like, me personally, I'm better than you are, because he's such a team player.
But is Artest the team's unspoken leader?
I would say he's the spoken leader on this team. Because, you know, when he has something to say, you know, he normally says it.
That seems to be a trait passed on to his daughter. Since Ron's fiance, Kamisha, gave birth to little Sadie 18 months ago, Artest has been forced to mature and focus on what's important to him.
Go Sadie, go Sadie.
When I think about her, in practice I go harder. I just go hard, or in the classrooms I just make sure I'm giving them my all to be the best student I could be. And just thinking about her made me want to just maximize my potential.
And if Ron does achieve all of his goals, back in the neighborhood where he learned the game, they'll think of him not only as a student or a father, but perhaps they'll see Artest as an artiste.
I would say that someday, you know, Ron Artest hopefully will become a Rembrandt.
Artest really is an all-around player. Just 2 weeks ago against Seton Hall, he had a triple-double, points, rebounds, and assists. Very talented young man. After that game concludes, our college basketball triple-header continues. Some of you will see South Carolina, 20th-ranked Syracuse, while others will check out Missouri and number 19 Kansas. Then, it's Mateen Cleaves and number 10 Michigan State at 18th-ranked Indiana. Thanks for watching Pennzoil at the Half, everyone. Vern Lundquist and Clark Kellogg will have the second half of Michigan at Purdue right after this.
Pennzoil at the Half has been sponsored by Pennzoil. Specially formulated for today's stop-and-go driving. Stop, go, Pennzoil.
Where'd you get the club?
Accounting.
County gave you a club?
Yeah, I made him a deal. Whenever my cell bills are half as much as yours, they give me a club.
Aren't you on the phone all the time?
Yeah, but I have Nextel. My calls are rounded to the second. I pay less.
That's not fair. I want to be rounded to the second.
Where do I get my putter?
Nextel's one-second rounding makes ordinary cell phones seem ordinary. And now, for a limited time, you can get Nextel phones starting at $99 each.
When you had the idea, you were just a kid. But lately, you've had to buy into some pretty adult stuff, like strategies for attracting and retaining the best employees and maximizing shareholder value. At Arthur Andersen, we help people make those kinds of decisions, which lets them concentrate on things like transforming complex three-dimensional objects into simple digital data. You know, kid stuff. Arthur Andersen, helping in ways you never imagined.
Dave's all new this week with Bill Murray, Shania Twain, Alicia Silverstone, James Brown, Sophia Loren, and Yasmin Bleeth. All this week on The Late Show.
The address is CBS.
Welcome home.
your people! Let's get on your feet and make some noise!
2 minutes. Two wah.
Let me tell you about this supernatural sense of smell I have. It's telling me I can get 5 roast beef sandwiches for only $5.95. Dig that slow roasted aroma. That's horse's sauce. No, wait, that's Arby's sauce. Any way you dress them up, you get 5 sweet smelling sandwiches for only $5.95. And I understand they look pretty good, too.
You can go anywhere and get filled up, but you can only get the 5 for $5.95 deal at Arby's.
Your Central Indiana Pontiac back dealers must reduce their inventory by February 28th to avoid personal property taxes. That means great values on all new 1999 Pontiacs. Plus, get factory incentives like 2.9% APR GMAC financing or huge cash back up to $2,000 or special lease offers. They must reduce their inventory or they pay personal property taxes. Hurry, while the selection is still good, to your Central Indiana Pontiac back dealers. But do it before February 28th.
We'll show you a new exhibit at the Children's Museum on Daybreak Sunday.
CBS Sports coverage of the road to the Final Four is sponsored by the United States Marine Corps. The change is forever. Arthur Anderson, helping in ways you never imagined. And by Nextel. You've never used a phone like this before.
We're back at Mackey Arena, West Lafayette, Indiana, where Purdue jumped out to that 7-0 lead, extended it to 18-4, and they have a comfortable lead at the half, 40-26. They had had offensive woes, but they've shot very well.
They really have. And again, shooting percentage always a function of the kinds of shots you get. Ball movement, player movement. Nice energizing effort by Carson Cunningham. And they had a very good offensive first half.
Well, let's take a look at the Kinko's halftime statistics. 40-26. 3-point shooting problems for both teams. Lewis Bullock, who had a 33-point effort last game out for Michigan, has been limited to 4 points, 1 of 8 from the field.
But we talked about their offense, the Boilermakers, that is. They shot well, assisted on over half of their made field goals, but defensively they've been very solid, especially when you look at the job 2 or 3 different guys have done on Lewis Bullock.
Cunningham misfires his first shot of the second half, but he ended the break with 12 points and sparked Purdue's lead. Here's Bullock off the cut, and it still will not go. He's 1 of 9 from the field now. Underneath at the other end, Cardinal is fouled hard by Asler. Second foul on Asler.
Purdue would love to be able to get out in transition at every opportunity. Cardinal gets behind the defenders and then pays for it as he gets hammered by Aslan. He'll shoot 2 free throws. Purdue did a nice job at the foul line in that first half as well. 11 of 14, I think they were.
Right. Cardinal's an 80% free throw shooter and gets the first. He'll shoot one more. Freshman Chris Young, number 45, on for Vic Neer now for Brian Ellerbee's team. Cardinal perfect at the line today.
Nice, nice easy way to get the scoring average up and to break out of a slump, get a bushel basket full of free throw attempts and makes.
Now Bullock picked up by Eldridge. Brandon Smith, he's guarded by Jerron Cornell. And Robbie Reed has Cunningham defending him. Young underneath. Aslan off his hand. And Aslan has some words of emphasis for his teammate.
Well, Young hesitated because Aslan had his man sealed. And by the time he decided to make the pass, he threw it too long.
Cardinal kicks it back outside to Eldridge. Now to Cornell on the quick touch pass underneath. Off Michigan, Purdue will inbound. And before the ball can be inbounded, Aslan picks up another quick foul.
Well, you made mention of it in the first half, Vern, how he had really had problems in the early part of the season keeping himself from Dean being DQ'd because of fouls. But he's gone back to his old ways today. Here you take a look at him and Cardinal. And Cardinal can kind of bait you into some of that stuff. I mean, he throws his body around, and he's a pretty clever player in doing so. I mean, it's frustrating when you're the opponent, but it's clever if you're on his squad.
So Aslan sits, Big Nair back on the floor for Michigan. Largest lead of the ball game is enhanced by the three-pointer. It's up to 19 points. Now McQuay fronts Young. Vic Neer, not the greatest shooter on the ball club. That one is out of bounds. Take a look at Cornell's last three-pointer.
Well, here you just take a look at good ball movement against the zone. Michigan going to be late getting to a shooter. And I don't know how you can forget about Cornell, 45% from behind the arc for his career. So you know when he catches it, he's very capable back there.
Big Deer. That one's tipped. Eldridge, and Bullock is not having his best day as it go off his hands and out of bounds.
And you mentioned not having his best day, and the margin of error when you only play seven guys and you don't get consistent production inside leaves the margin very slim, and Lewis is struggling, as are the Wolverines, with turnovers. You see Purdue is taking full advantage of almost every one of them.
Cornell in and out. Young gets it to Reed. Now Reed tries to force it up. Pulls up and Cans takes the three. Cans it.
So that's the one thing that if you're Purdue, you have to worry about. This looks like a very comfortable lead right now. But Michigan, much like they haven't won back-to-back games since Thanksgiving, they haven't put together back-to-back field goals in this game.
If they could do that,
if they could do that, they might be able to get back in it. But so far, it hasn't happened.
Robbie Reed has led the way thus far for Michigan.
Yeah, he's been their only consistent offensive weapon. And here, Carson Cunningham just retreats too deep to the paint. And by the time he recognizes that Reed's out there alone, it's too late.
And Vic Neer picked up his third foul, so he and Aslan both with three. Greg McQuay, 58% from the free throw line. Spent 2 years playing at the College of Southern Idaho and transferred in this year, along with his coach, Jim Thrash, who's now on the staff with Gene Katie. And has been really solid for Purdue this year.
Rock solid. Double figures in his last seven games as you take a look at Jim Thrash.
On the inbound play, Young is tied up by McQuay. Aslan, playing with three, will replace Big Neer, who sits with three. Possession arrow was in favor of Michigan. Here's Reed to Bullock. Alan Eldridge has done a terrific job defensively today. Reed with the dish. Brandon Smith with a jumper after he finally gains control.
Boy, that was a tremendous example of wonderful hands as he gained control of that ball on the fumble and dribble and then knocked down the shot.
Cardinal. And McQuay was the last to touch it.
You can't teach these kind of hands. Controlling on the dribble in traffic. Nice patience here. And knocks down a much-needed hoop.
Chris Young has suffered a cut, so he has to head to the bench. And Young being tended to by the medical staff, trainers.
He probably took a shot right above his left eye, and that's the most sensitive area. Boxers know all about it, but I've had stitches on both sides of my face from just a sharp elbow or just a nudge right above that eye area.
It hasn't enhanced your good looks.
Why did I set you up?
46-31.
I forgot how quick-witted you
could be. Oh, yeah, no. Like walking in a sandstorm. 46-31. Bullock.
I think this is really a critical juncture here, Vern, because if Michigan is going to make a game out of this, they need a surge now to energize themselves. Otherwise, if Purdue is able to maintain this comfort zone, that's just what it'll be, a comfort zone. Michigan has to penetrate this comfort zone Purdue's been in most of the game. To do that, they've got to defend and score on top of it.
Cunningham back on the floor. Penetration.
Wow. Wow.
Got it up and over the 6'11 Aslan.
I took a break from my broadcast position during halftime and ran into his mom, Susie, and she was all smiles. As well she should be. Carson Cunningham. This is his second acrobatic shot today. Penetration and production.
14 points as a starter. Replaced Mike Robinson, who'd been averaging just under 10 points per game. This is not a season high for Carson Cunningham. He had 18 points against Valparaiso early in the season, but it's been a magnificent effort so far.
Okay, babe, here we go. Now, move over to the right. No, the other way, my right. A little more. A little more. Perfect.
How was it?
Beautiful.
If you think the Cavalier looks good, wait till you know it can go up to 100,000 miles before its first scheduled tune-up. Chevy Cavalier. The more you know, the better it looks. Genuine Chevrolet.
It is more than a trial by fire. It is a rite of passage. And if you can master your fear, outsmart your enemy, and never yield, even to yourself, you will be changed forever. The few, the proud, the Marines.
Starting a small business takes a burning entrepreneurial spirit, a singular, bold vision, the courage to fight an endless uphill battle. But that's not all you need. Oh, no.
We need some furniture.
And some curtains would be nice. That's why you need the Visa business card. Because Jules Seltzer furniture, like millions of other places, doesn't take any card from American Express.
I love these chairs.
And I'm really happy with these window treatments.
What? Visa business card. It's everywhere you want to be.
Visa honors America's Olympians, like Eric Namesnick of the University of Michigan, who swam in 1992 and won the silver in 96. And Purdue University's Ray Urey, who won a total of 10 gold medals in track and field at the 1900, 04, 06, and 08 games. Visa will donate $1,000 to each of these universities and $1,000 to the U.S. Olympic team for their efforts in the development of our future Olympians.
Was he hot-dogging, being a cowboy, when his jet severed a cable on a ski slope in Italy, killing 20 people? His story Sunday on 60 Minutes.
And is the Arthur Anderson wise decision of the game? We're going to give it to the coach, Gene Cady, for starting Carson Cunningham.
Yeah, it's been a masterful move, as so is this move by Cunningham himself. He's really energized the Boilermaker offense, and that's one of the reasons I think Gene Cady decided to start him, because he felt as though Carson might give him some of that impetus they lacked on offense, and he certainly has today.
Cady said yesterday that their big problem this season has been the point guard position. And he's got to be really pleased with what he's gotten out of that spot.
Without question.
15:50 to go in regulation. Here's Brandon Smith. Robbie Reed. Bullock pops out. Still can't get the shot. Mike Robinson on him now. And that one goes up and in. And he draws a foul. So he's closing in on 2,000 for his career.
When an outstanding scorer has struggled all game long, this is the kind of play that sometimes can ignite a flurry. Penetration, contact, and finish.
has a chance now to make it a three-point play.
Really an outstanding young man. Very poised, well-spoken. He's fired a lot of blanks today, but the gunslingers always continue to shoot. And he might find a role because they'll need it if they're going to get back in it. I think he's the guy that has to make it happen for Michigan.
Cornell picked up defensively by Bullock. Tony Mayfield on the floor now, number 20. Entry pass to Cameron Stevens, has it rejected by Aslan. Here comes Brandon Smith. Mayfield back defensively. And Smith will pull it back outside. Bullock to Reed. 14 points, Purdue lead. Bullock goes baseline. Stevens is there to help defend. And a foul called on Purdue.
Well, if you're going to come back from a deep hole, you need to do it defensively. Nice positioning here by Aslan. He's playing with three fouls. But he's able to deny Stevens that trip and give his team a chance for another possession.
Whoa, no. He called it.
Watch out.
That basket and the foul seem to have gotten Bullock untracked. And the lead is 11.
Vern, you've been around the game long enough to know when good players get it going and Jerron Cornell answers it. I know back-to-back buckets don't sound like a lot, but when you've gone 1-for-10, making two in a row could be huge.
Cornell counters for Purdue. He's got 13 points. Here's Reed off the glass. No.
You see what's so important for Lewis Bullock is that he's the guy the other players look to. So if he gets going, it can ignite the other guys. And you see he's crossed over the 2K barrier, joining some illustrious company there. Mike McGee, a guy I played against, Gary Grant, Glenn Rice, and Cassie Russell, one of the great college players, went on to a successful pro career and just a dynamic, dynamite guy.
See, I like it because we cover your era.
We got them all covered there.
And then we go back to mine.
There was somebody from the 60s, 70s, 80s.
Right.
Now, there was somebody from every decade, the last four.
Robbie Reed with one more free throw.
Tell you what, if his shot doesn't go straight in, it has no chance because there's no rotation on that ball, so I don't think it'll ever get any play on the rim.
Reed with 16, there's a Purdue turnover.
But if you're going to shoot him right down the middle, you don't need any play on the iron.
Eldridge back on Bullock. Bullock pops out, takes the shot. Nope, rebound. Gary McQuay. Brandon Smith knocks it out of bounds. It'll be Purdue ball. 51-39. Greg McQuay will come on for his brother. And Eldridge, Tony Mayfield in the backcourt now for Purdue. Eldridge. Entry pass from Cornell. Greg McQuay. Out of control. And another Purdue turnover. That's three quick turnovers for the Boilermakers. Time has been called. Back at Mackey Arena, Leon Jones. Bullock to Jones. Offensive board for Brandon Smith.
Oh, my! Oh, did he want to get to the hole or what there? Great work by Brandon Smith on the offensive glass, and what a take from the wing to the cup with flair and authority.
Smith has 10. Cornell is fouled by Brandon Smith.
Oh, the young fella got me excited here. Look at how much ground he covered with one dribble in the extension. Oh, yeah, that's how you do it. With authority, young fella.
Now Smith watches as Cornell shoots two.
quietly, the Boilermakers have gotten it. I mean, Michigan has gotten it back to within 10. Now it's back to 11. But you can sense, because Michigan changed defenses a little bit, went to the man-to-man, forced some turnovers, that they're starting to get maybe a little momentum. Brian Ellerbe on a rest bullet, try to get him a quick blow. The under 12-minute timeout will come at some point, and I imagine Bullock would probably be back right after that.
Lewis Bullock, out of Maryland, has made it a quintet among those in Michigan history who scored more than 2,000. But Purdue answers now, and it's back to a 12-point margin. Here's Brandon Smith. Nope. Haslin, saved by Cardinal. Foul called on Michigan.
That is not a wise play by the Wolverines. They've got a little momentum going. They had the rebounder hemmed in. Just keep your hands up. Don't reach in and foul the guy way back there.
Robbie Reed picks up his third. Five team fouls on the Wolverines. Matt Cunningham and Ron Oliver, number 24, has come on. His first appearance. And Brandon Smith. Oh, man.
You love his athleticism, his quickness to the ball, good hands. As he develops a perimeter shot and just gets stronger, he's going to be some kind of player. Look at him help his teammate out here, Josh Ashland, who had joined the Paratroopers Club on the pump fake, but clearly a goaltender.
Reed guarded by Cunningham. Penetration has to alter the shot, and a foul called underneath.
I think they called it on Reed.
If so, that's four. Twenty-second timeout called by Michigan.
And Vern, you can see why Michigan is struggling on the road. They got the game back into a manageable position, and then got a little helter-skelter. Now it's back to 14.
Triple header for you tomorrow. We'll tip it off with a terrific matchup. Second-ranked Duke goes into Madison Square Garden to take on St. John's. Then regional coverage. Some will see South Carolina against Syracuse. Others will watch Missouri take on Kansas. Clark and I are going to move down to the southern part of the state, to Bloomington. We'll watch Michigan State and Indiana as the third game of our triple-header coverage tomorrow.
How about that, Vern? The band was playing the theme song for College Hoops on CBS without being cued. Isn't that something? They're all over it.
Well, you pay what we did for rights fees and word seeps out. Last Tuesday against Ohio State, Purdue shot 32%. They had 43 points in that game.
Well, as George Karl would say, the former coach of the Seattle Sonics and now coach of the Bucks, that was what you would call a calm game. Nothing went right from the start, and if you could have, you would have forfeited it 5 minutes in if you were Purdue.
A 6-0 run by the Boilermakers. Ball on the floor. Cunningham goes down. Hell ball, possession arrow, Purdue.
Mm-hmm.
Well, the Wolverines made a run and got within 10. Purdue has responded after Brandon Smith's basket with 6 in a row.
Meet Chris Wirth, animator. Knows good, knows evil, knows that having a formidable partner is definitely good. Chevy S10, like a rock. The address is CBS. Welcome home. Silverado. It has a more powerful V8 engine than Dodge Ram and Ford F-150. It has a bigger extended cab. And it's the only pickup with four-wheel anti-lock disc brakes standard on every model. It's the truck. The Motor Trend Truck of the Year. Silverado, the truck from Chevrolet.
The blizzard conditions in some areas of the country cause many people to miss our biggest sale of the year, H.H. Gregg's annual New Year's Day sale, with employee family discount prices on everything in the store. Because of the bad weather, H.H. Gregg is extending our New Year's Day sale at all of our stores for 2 days only, this Friday and Saturday. Buy name brand appliances, electronics, and computers at the low prices reserved for employee families only. Don't miss H.H. Gregg's extended New Year's Day sale, this Friday and Saturday only.
Kimberly Harms talks with Sam Perkins tonight on Sports Soccer.
From Wish TV, your 24-hour news station, here's the latest from News 8.
Boilermakers trying to halt a mini skid. They've dropped their last two Big Ten games at home against Indiana and at Ohio State. They lead by 16 here tonight on CBS. To save a kid from his drug-dealing dad, the LAPD's dynamic duo become Kindergarten Cops. Sammo Hung and Arsenio Hall star in the all-new Martial Law tonight on CBS. 11:56 remaining in Mackey Arena as the Boilermakers trying to go 3-3 in Big Ten play. How about your Ohio State Buckeyes?
Quite impressive today. They've shocked me the last two games. I knew they were good and quick and solid defensively, but the way they've handled two pretty good teams in Purdue and Minnesota by a combined 30-point margin in each is very, very impressive.
That ball out of bounds off Aslan. And will be inbounded by Purdue. Allen Eldridge, number 15, whose contribution primarily has been defensive today.
And it has been outstanding.
Reach in foul. Ron Oliver gets this one. Senior one-time walk-off.
Excuse me, Vern, but Michigan has really put themselves in a tough position. Typically, games have ebbs and flows to them during the course of a 40-minute college game. Purdue jumped out on top early here, have maintained a pretty good comfort zone. About 3 minutes ago, Michigan had got the lead down to 10 after it had been, you know, 12, 14, 16 points most of the game, and they made a couple of crucial errors, and now they're already over the limit with their team foul situation. So they can't be quite as aggressive as they would like to be without the risk of fouling and sending Purdue to the line to squelch any type of run they might try to make. So it's a real uphill battle from here on out for Michigan. But if they can get Lewis, Bullock, and Reed to knock down some threes, they've got a chance.
Jones misses that, gets his own, follows it off the glass for two. Cunningham gets the inbound pass. That had been the largest lead of the game at 18. And eight unanswered points for Purdue. Now Cunningham, guarded by Ron Oliver. Entry pass and a foul called on Bullock underneath. That's the third foul on Lewis Bullock. Mike Robinson coming back into the game now for Purdue. And Brian Cardinal will get a rest for Michigan. Peter Vigneer replaces Ron Oliver. Michigan team that had three really impressive wins in the Big Ten at home. But different story when they got outside of the market.
And part of that is youth. They're a very young basketball team outside of Reed and Bullock, who both are seniors. And Reed an older than normal senior because of the two-year Mormon mission he took.
With the conclusion of today's game, we'll select the Chevrolet Most Valuable Player of the Game from each team. Chevrolet will make a contribution to each school's general scholarship fund. That, of course, is tradition for over a quarter of a century.
See, if you're Purdue now, you just need to be smart with the ball. Move yourselves, have good spacing, and then knock down your free throws when you get fouled. Don't give Michigan any opportunities to score easy baskets. Make them work for everything, which has pretty much been the case for the 29 minutes we've played so far.
Chad Kirkhoff, number 11, on the floor now for Gene Katie's Purdue bunch. Joined by Mayfield, here's Bullock. Nice little leaner, got the shooter's touch and draws the foul, will go to the free throw line.
Lewis Bullock does a nice little job here of taking advantage of the curl move and the defender coming out not on balance to get a shoulder by, and then he's under enough control to concentrate on the shot and drawing the contact.
8 second half points. And Carson Cunningham favoring that left leg. Not sure what the difficulty is, but the trainer working with him on the Purdue bench. Kirkhoff, number 11. Mike Robinson. Eldridge kicks it back to Kirkhoff. Into the corner. Robinson, no. Brandon Smith with the rebound for Michigan. They leave him open for the three, and he'll pass. Here's Bullock. Smith pulls it back outside. No basket. Foul called.
Wow, Lewis Bullock may have gotten away with a little push off there. He got that left arm out quite a bit away from his body. Let's take a peek. Watch the left arm of Lewis Bullock. Right there. And if that's where the foul was whistled, Lewis Bullock created all of that contact. Only 16 fouls on Purdue. Make it 7 now as Bullock got cross body blocked as he tried to shake free in the corner.
So Michigan will go to the 1-1, and Cunningham, having received the trainer's attention, he is back on the floor now for Tony Mayfield. That's not a surprise, the 29-17 disparity.
That is pretty much the norm, and typically when they've played well, the front court has given them solid contributions. That's not really been the case today, especially from Josh Aslan. But they're still just kind of hanging around here, Vern. And that's always dangerous when you have the capability of making the three-point shot the way Michigan does. I mean, dangerous for Purdue.
And another run, a mini run now for the Wolverines. Has cut the margin to 12. They're on a 7-1 run. Here's Robinson and Brian Cardinal. This foul is going to be whistled on Purdue.
Moving screen. Gene Katie doesn't like it, nor do the 14,000 plus here. But you have to be square and stationary when you're setting a screen. And it appeared that Carson Cunningham was the guilty party. Let's take a look. There's Carson Cunningham. Just slid right into Lewis Bullock. Good call.
So Bullock goes back to the free throw line, where he is perfect today at 6 of 6. And superb. He leads the Big Ten in free throw percentage.
Vern, what could happen here is if Michigan gets this game to within 6 or 8, the whole complexion changes. Purdue has been comfortably skating along. 18-point lead, 12-point lead, 16. This thing gets down to 6 or 8, and it changes everything. And that's what Michigan is hoping for. They're hoping at some point within the next few minutes to disrupt the comfort zone of Purdue.
And for the second time in this half, it is a 10-point game. Last time, Purdue responded with 8 unanswered. There's Eldridge. Greg McQuaid. Back to Cardinal for 3. McNear rebounds for Michigan. And here comes Boyd. Underneath, Cardinal. McNear saves it. Jones spots up for an open look. And the game is at 7. And Gene Katie calls timeout.
And Gene Katie is livid because he feels what I just talked about. This thing slipping away a little bit. There's a tendency to get complacent when things have gone so easy for you. And then when it gets tighter, the team that's led becomes a little tentative. As we take a look, the ball gets sprayed around and Jones gets the fortuitous bounce and knocks down a big triple.
Coming up tonight on CBS, America's Night of Heroes begins with Early Edition. Then Sammo Hung and Arsenio Hall go undercover as kindergarten cops in an all-new martial law. That's followed by Chuck Norris in Walker, Texas Ranger. It's all right here tonight on CBS.
Nobody has a better scowl that contrasts his personality more than Gene Katie.
7-point game with 9:13 to go. McNear guards McQuay. Now Cornell.
I think we got Aslan and Cardinal down there getting to know each other, as we like to say in the business, thumping and bumping down in that paint. Left part of your screen, actually the center of your screen, right inside where the Big Ten is inside the lane, and that's Cardinal and Aslan.
Aslan picks up his fourth. Just to be redundant for a moment, he has fouled out of 8 games this year, but only one since Big Ten play began. And in trouble now, and Cardinal misses a free throw.
See, that's the kind of thing that momentum does. All those free throws going down early. Now Purdue has to come up with a defensive stop here.
Jones, Bullock, quick off the dribble, the leaner in and out, McNear offensive board. Brings it back outside and puts it in the hands of Brandon Smith. McQuay punts on McNear. Offensive foul, Michigan.
McNear got the elbow up a little too high and active. You can get the elbow up about chest high, but it has to be fairly stationary. If you start moving it towards that defender, you're going to be whistled for a foul.
And McNear picks up his fourth. That sends Greg McQuay to the line.
Boy, Michigan got a great shot for Bullock that just wouldn't go down on that last possession. They could have cut it to 5.
This is not a particularly good free throw shooting team, with the exception of a couple, and Greg McQuay misses the first. He's at 58% for the season. So on balance, it should go in. You'll notice, though, that I delayed that.
Yeah, with a nice pause in there.
Back to an 8-point margin. Jones, Bullock, kicks it back outside. Jones, off the mark. McNear might have gotten away with a push.
Well, down in there, Vern, you know you're going to have some hand wrestling and arm wrestling. That was a great effort by McNear to come up with another offensive rebound. He leads the Big Ten in that category.
Foul away from the ball again. This one goes against Purdue.
Things are starting to pick up. It's starting to get a little testy down there. I mean, an awful lot of contact going on, bodies bumping, guys grabbing. And still a lot of time left. Still just over 8 minutes to go.
For his career, Lewis Bullock, 87% from the line. And perfect today.
Look at the work by McNear to come up with this offensive rebound. Oh, see, that's just good work there. Contact, but incidental. Nothing illegal there. Rebounding is all about tenacity, positioning, and timing. Jumping ability doesn't factor in as much as those three things.
Whoa, a rare miss for Bullock. 88% for this season, And he finally misfires.
How many second half points for Bullock, Mike?
Cornell. Loses control as he tries to penetrate. Here's Brandon Smith. Cunningham gets back and takes the foul. And it's going to be called intentional.
And again, people are going to disagree with that call. But it's right on target within the spirit and letter of the rule. Brandon Smith appears to have a breakaway layup here. And there's not much attempt to get to the ball. And Brandon came up limping just a bit. And it doesn't necessarily have to be an attempt on the ball. If it's deemed to be excessive contact in the eyes of the official, then that could warrant the intentional foul call as well. But I think that clearly was a fact that a case of where Cunningham just tried to grab him to keep him from a breakaway layup.
How about this? The margin is 5.
Was someone cue the music?
Louis, what are you doing?
My family has been in this swamp,
Louis,
for over 5,000 years.
Louis, I'm begging you.
During Prohibition, when the swamp ran dry, my family pulled together. My great-grandfather, the worm master.
Louis, that's enough.
And my grandfather, the fly master.
That's enough, Louis.
Gathered up the flies and the worms to be saved and handed down that brilliant tradition to me, Louis.
Oh, Louis, you're begging for a pink slip.
America's got gumption.
Ain't nobody crying.
The kind of can-do spirit that's in every Chevy Malibu.
Ain't nobody worried.
A car so carefully crafted, so darn tootin' tough, it can go up to 100,000 miles before its first scheduled tune-up. Yes, sir, it's gumption on wheels. The car you knew America could build. Malibu. Genuine Chevrolet.
I'm a junior VP, and all the junior VPs have one of these. So I'll just call my secretary, and then she'll... voicemail. Chuck number 4 is down.
Gotcha. I'm a mailroom guy, and all the mailroom guys get to see the phones that the senior VPs get.
Nextel's two-way radio feature makes ordinary cell phones seem ordinary. And now, for a limited time, you can get Nextel phones starting at $99 each.
Breakthrough to the new world of Mach 3 from Gillette. The first triple blade shaving system. Three blades specially positioned to shave progressively closer. You take one stroke, it takes three. So you don't have to shave the same area over and over, which means less irritation. Three blades, fewer strokes, less irritation. Mach 3 from Gillette.
Wolverines found themselves down by 14 points in the first 5 minutes of this game. They have been tenacious, and they crawl back in it. It's a 5-point margin in the second half, 42-42. And Lewis Bullock has led the way 1 of 8 at halftime break. So what's been the change?
I think part of it has been Michigan has just persisted in staying around. Bullock's been able to get better shots. He's been able to move better without the ball, and he got himself going by knocking down a shot and getting fouled. Dribble penetration.
And before the inbounds play, there is another foul on Michigan. Both teams in the double bonus. This one on Chris Young, his second, and Cunningham at the line. Garson Cunningham, the sophomore, his first start here. He's 6 of 7 at the line. Has a chance now to match his season high.
I think he's still bothered by whatever his leg ailment is, Vern. We didn't get a report on that. I don't know if it's a knee or an ankle or a hamstring or calf, but I guess I covered the whole leg there, didn't I?
Yeah. Way to be specific. Oh, my goodness. Stolen after it was thrown. Eldridge for two. Brandon Smith got a little aggressive in trying to get it into the backcourt. Alan Eldridge steals it. Bullock, Young. They give him the shot. He travels.
Aaron Paz leads to this opportunity for Eldridge. And Bullock just kind of slowed up there, expecting Eldridge maybe to get it and pull out. And Eldridge went strong to the basket and got a much-needed deuce for Purdue. They had stagnated offensively, as you take a look. Not a lot of turnovers for Michigan, but as we saw earlier, Purdue had done a nice job converting those turnovers into points.
Cunningham drives and has it stripped away. Chris Young is on the bench after the violation.
Cunningham gets a slight step by Smith, but then the quick hands. We talked about the good hands of Smith, the evidence of them there.
Cunningham, ball away. Blocked by Smith into the hands of Aslan and knocked out of bounds by Cardinal.
Cardinal lucky not to get a foul there.
And full court pressure now applied by Purdue. 56-64, 6:45 to go. John Aslan's back on the floor. He replaced Young. Here's Robbie Reed, who plays with four fouls and had to rest for quite some time because of that. And Bullock, who's been the key to the second half comeback. Brandon Smith, guarded by Cunningham, takes him off the dribble, foul. Offensive.
Michigan now starting to falter a bit. You take a look at Smith, trying to create a space where there is none, as Brian Cardinal just does a nice job of helping out defensively and giving up his body.
Cardinal back at the free throw line. 7 of 8 today. And a chance to get back to a double-digit lead. Remaining. Bullock guarded by Eldridge. Screen from Aslan on the pick and roll. Nice defensive switch by Cardinal. Saved by Smith underneath Aslan. Whoa! Thunder dunk.
He made sure of that. Well, Michigan just kind of hanging around. Purdue has gotten a little more breathing room, but still an awful lot of time to go.
Cunningham.
And Michigan, despite the foul trouble, has stayed primarily in the man-to-man defense, which has been an important part of their comeback as well.
They have three men on the floor playing with four fouls apiece. Reed, Vigneer, Aslan. Three-pointer, no. Bullock is fouled in the backcourt.
Well, I tell you what. I like to see good basketball and smart playing. You can't always try to come up with a steal when a guy clearly has a rebound. Concede the fact that the ball has changed possessions and get back and play defense. Especially in this kind of situation, that's what Michigan wants. Opportunities to chip into the lead with the clock stop. And that's a couple of times now where both teams have done it today, where they've reached in unnecessarily and committed a foul when a guy clearly has the rebound in his possession.
Well, two things about that. Cardinal picks up his fourth, and Lewis Bullock goes to the free throw line.
That's a bad combination any way you look at it. I mean, Lewis is a 90% free throw shooter, and Cardinal is an important part of what Purdue tries to do at both ends of the floor.
Go. 11-12 at the line. Lewis Bullock, and it's back to six.
This is where you have to have people make plays. you can talk all about systems and this, that, and the other, but when it comes down to a game that's in the balance, you got to have people make plays.
Cameron Stevens underneath on the miss, but he can't get the shot to go, and here comes Robbie Reed. A chance to cut the lead to 4-3. There's the pass underneath. Bullock, oh boy.
How did he get that ball on the iron? I can't believe he gets that ball up on the rim. Switched hands, was off balance. Nice backdoor cut. The pass was just a little off the mark. Nice job to recover. And then go up. Not a lot of contact by Stevens there. I think that's what Katie was upset about. He didn't think there was a foul committed from that replay angle. There wasn't an awful lot of contact.
Amazing.
It really is. I mean, you won't see that in the same game from Bullock for a long time.
I think that's only the second time this year he's missed two in a game.
I still don't mind sending him to the line come money time or game time. He'd still be the guy I'd shoot. Even more so that he's missed two already. You figure the rest of them he's going to knock down.
In the corner for Purdue, back in the hands of Eldridge. Here's Cunningham, takes the jumper off the glass. And Josh Aslan has just committed his fifth foul. Four points. Six rebounds, five fouls. Second time in Big Ten play that the 6'11 sophomore from Carroll, Michigan has fouled out.
You look at his 4 points and think he didn't really have a productive game, but he didn't get a lot of touches, really didn't get a lot of opportunities. When you have a guard-oriented offense, sometimes the big guys don't get the touches that you'd like to see them get.
And at the line, Cameron Stevens gets the first. You saw Aslan as he went to the bench being consoled by the assistant coach, Kirk Townsend, who played for Gene Katie,
right,
Western Kentucky, back in the late 70s.
And spent time before coming here as an assistant with Ben Braun out of California.
Now Reed. Lead is at 7 with 4:25 to go.
Actually, he was with Todd Bozeman as an assistant. I correct myself there.
In the lane, Bullock. Saved underneath. Young. Too strong. The putback by Vic Mier. 68-63. Cameron Stevens, Eldridge, Cunningham, Greg McQuay, and Jerron Cornell. Here's the three-pointer.
Yes! Big shot there. He's quiet, but he is so effective. And he doesn't need much space or time to get his shot off.
Quick release from Cornell with 20 points now, and the lead is at 8. Bullock.
He's looking for the contact. I'm still trying to figure out how he makes that with the left hand on his way down.
Oh, my goodness. 19 second half points for Bullock.
Boy, him and Cornell really going at each other. And part of the reason Bullock may have struggled in that first half, we didn't mention it, is because he had to really extend himself defensively on Cornell, who's had a solid offensive game.
Five on the shot clock. Cunningham pulls up and takes it and hands it. Foul called as Brandon Smith goes for the drive. Carson Cunningham, a season high 20 points today, his first game as a starter for Purdue.
And I just mentioned how you need guys to step up and make plays. Two big threes, one by Cornell, and this one by Cunningham as the shot clock is winding down, and Michigan has done a pretty good job defensively. That's just a huge shot by C squared. We'll call him from here on out, Carson Cunningham.
Cameron Stevens heads to the bench. Brian Cardinal comes back on, and Brandon Smith is at the line. 2 minutes and 44 seconds remain in regulation.
The truck. The award. The new Chevy Silverado. The Motor Trend Truck of the Year. It's bigger, it's more powerful. It's the truck from Chevrolet. Like a rock. Oh, like a
rock. Now that is a sweet investment.
You have a retirement plan?
Oh, sure. Invest, get rich, retire at 45.
Well, I'm 58.
Huh? Oh, your retirement plan.
Who's looking out for your investments? E-Trade, the number one rated place to invest online with free real-time quotes, 10 times more research, smart alerts, all from $14.95. Isn't it time you looked out for number one? Call 1-800-E-TRADE-1 and see why someday we'll all invest this way.
Are you concerned about losing more hair? Do you wonder how much further it will go? Do you wish you could do something about it? Well, there's a pill for men with certain types of hair loss. It's called Propecia. In clinical studies, the vast majority of men, 83%, maintain their current hair count, and most, 66%, regrew some hair. Take it daily and you could see results in as little as 3 months. Propecia is for men only. A small number of men experience certain sexual side effects. Each occurred in less than 2% of men. Women who are or may potentially be pregnant must not use it or handle broken tablets because of the risk of a specific kind of birth defect. Talk to your doctor or pharmacist and read the consumer information they can provide. Propecia, helping make hair loss history.
Call it destiny. With seconds left, freshman shoots and North Carolina wins by one. The kid's name, Michael Jordan. March Madness on CBS.
Well, if you don't love that shot, you got no soul. 74-67. All ages enjoying this one. 22 Purdue points off 13 Michigan turnovers.
That's a good ratio of capitalizing on the turnovers. I mean, sometimes teams turn it over, but if you don't make points out of them, it sometimes can be kind of a meaningless stat.
That's the CBS Sportsline stat of the game. And for complete college basketball coverage, go to cbs.sportsline.com.
I read somewhere that you can torture statistics into saying whatever you want them to say. But clearly, one of the huge differences is that Purdue has turned turnovers into points.
And they have protected the ball. That's not the case, been the case every game this year.
Right.
Only 8 turnovers so far for Purdue. Here's Cunningham. Cardinal, shot clock under 10. Cardinal with a spin move and a terrific adjustment, and then the shot won't go, but he gets his own shot. A rebound, and back into Cunningham's hands.
They'll get some additional clock time now. They'll try to maximize it, and then look to Cornell or Cunningham to try to make a play.
Twice in this half, Michigan has climbed to within 5. They had a chance to get within 4. And Cunningham's shot won't go. Dick Neer with a rebound.
Well, he's done a nice job on both backboards. Pete Big Neer.
That's 11 rebounds for Big Neer. Bullock. Good block. Hell ball.
On the simultaneous block, which forces a held ball, it automatically goes to the defense. Lewis Bullock trying to draw contact here. and likes to shoot that shot on his way down and got tied up, and Perdue will have it again with a chance to kill some more clock.
Cunningham brings it back out, 1:15 to go. Alan Eldridge guarded by Robbie Reed.
Well, Perdue has shown the heart that Coach Katie talked about after the loss Tuesday. They came out with energy. They maintained a pretty good lead most of the way. And when Michigan threatened, they pulled one. They pulled it back out.
Reed misses the long distance shot. Cardinal gets out of trouble, puts it in the hands of Eldridge, and
got a foul.
45.
You got a foul. Michigan allowed about 8 or 9 seconds to elapse. You got a foul immediately.
Third foul on Chris Young. Well, our Chevrolet players of the game for Michigan, Lewis Bullock, who scored 19 points in the second half and helped propel Michigan back into the thick of this game, and Carson Cunningham. That shot taken before he got the haircut.
Right, exactly.
Self-induced on Wednesday with a season high of 20 points. Eldridge gets the first. Cunningham, who says his hobby is reading, left practice here yesterday. He said he'd been reading Somerset Maugham's Of Human Bondage. It was too depressing. So he went for Dumas' The Count of Monte Cristo.
Whatever works.
Back it goes. Brandon Smith in the lane. Ryan Cardinal, I think, has just fouled out. If this is on him, that's fine. And that's a bemused smile on the face of Gene Katie.
He's got a full arsenal of those looks, doesn't he? He's got the scowl,
yep,
the smirk, right, and he's really a wonderful coach and a fun guy to talk to.
Brian Cardinal fouls out with 11 points. Gary McQuay comes on now, number 5 for Perdue. And Brandon Smith at the line. Gene Katie, 19 years here. They have averaged 12 Big Ten wins per season. Brandon Smith misses the first. Katie said, that's not easy.
It sure isn't. Especially in a conference that typically is one of the best in the country. And this year, by consensus, when you look at the balance in the conference, is the best league in the country, right alongside of the Pac-10, I might add.
22nd timeout called by Brian Ellaby and the Michigan Wolverines. 75-68 with 33.8 left. Triple header for you tomorrow, and what a way to tip off the afternoon. Second-ranked Duke goes into Madison Square Garden to play St. John's. Then regional coverage, South Carolina, Syracuse, and Missouri, Kansas. And then the final game, Michigan State against Indiana. It begins tomorrow at 12 o'clock Eastern time. 33.8 left in regulation. Boilermakers up by 7.
If this is you, there are no boundaries to how you think. Just imagine if there were no boundaries to how you communicate. It will happen starting January 31st. This is your network. If this is you, communications has finally caught up with the way you live. Starting January 31st, this is your network.
Craig, I don't know.
Fair enough. Maybe this will help.
As you can see, I love you more than anything in the world.
Note the dramatic increase in the past 7 months. This shows how much we have in common. My 10-year gross earnings potential. A composite of what our kids might look like.
I like what you've done here, Craig.
Sometimes it's not just what you say, but how you say it. Kinko's. Express yourself.
In the old days, they didn't have the advantage of shaped skis. They didn't have powdered wax. They didn't have quick release bindings. And worst of all, the U.S. ski team didn't have Chevy Trucks as its sponsor.
Bummer.
one the U.S. ski team depends on.
The LAPD's dynamic duo become...
I'm your substitute teacher.
Kindergarten cop. All new Martial Law, CBS Tonight.
CBS Sports coverage of the road to the Final Four is sponsored by Chevrolet Trucks, the most dependable, longest-lasting trucks on the road. Bud Light, for the great taste that won't fill you up and never lets you down, make it a Bud Light. And by Propecia, talk to your doctor today.
33.8 left in regulation. Michigan up, or rather down by 7, 33.8 to go. Alan Eldridge getting set to inbound.
You go for the quick steal if you're Michigan and then the immediate foul.
And Bullock foul's coming in.
If you don't get the turnover right away, you send somebody to the line. You would have rather sent somebody else. Cunningham has been good in every aspect of his game today.
Gene Cady, 19th season here, actually spent time at Arkansas as an assistant, then got his first head coaching job at Western Kentucky, first coaching job, head coaching job in Division I. And look at the comparison with Bobby Knight in the Big Ten. Fairly favorable, huh?
Not too shabby. Tit for tat.
Taken away underneath by Greg McQuay. Reed fouled out. Robbie Reed, 16 points. Much of that in the first half. He was made much less of a force because of foul trouble here in the second.
Well, today may have been a case again of Michigan fighting to get back into it and just not having enough plays made down the stretch to get through that wall of resistance. And you've got to give Purdue credit. They made a couple of big shots after Michigan had cut double-digit leads down to 6 points.
Here's the lineup for CBS Tonight. We'll begin with early edition and then Martial Law and finally Walker, Texas Ranger. That's tonight on CBS. Eldridge. 11-point margin. Here's Bullock off the mark. And another foul. Foul called on Cameron Stevens. Well, Michigan's going to go to 3-4 in Big Ten play. 9-11 for the season. And 1-6 on the road. They get back home where they have defeated Wisconsin, Indiana, and Ohio State. And Jones misfires. Jones one of two this trip. 18 seconds remaining. Into the hands of Gary McQuay. Taken away by Ron Oliver. Brandon Smith, no. Bullock puts it up and in. And with 8.3 seconds, it's an 8-point game. Oliver goes for the steal. Jones fouls Cunningham. Gene Cady, another. He does have the full contingent, doesn't he?
Oh, sure. He'll feel a lot better after this one than he did after last Saturday and certainly last Tuesday. They dropped games to Indiana here and then Ohio State on the road. You look at this conference, Michigan State, the only team with one loss right now. They have a tough game tomorrow at Indiana. And you try to figure out what it's going to take to win the conference. Probably somewhere in the neighborhood, 3-4, maybe even 5 losses.
Mm-hmm.
Could end up being your conference champion before the Big Ten tournament.
Lane violation, so Carson Cunningham gets another, and now he gets a standing ovation. season-high 24 points for Carson Cunningham in his first start. Oliver at the other end, and this one's in the books. Gene Cady said, we haven't been in this bad of funk since 1989. Well, they're a little less funkier right now than they were 2 hours ago. A 10-point margin of victory propelled by Carson Cunningham. Purdue wins it. They go to 3-3 in Big Ten play.